Good morning, my dear students. So in this PPT, I'm going to explain you about the fluid conditioning through filters and strainer. What are the main use of filter and strainers in a hydraulic power system? Okay, so this is very important parts of hydraulic power system. Filters and strainers both are used to filter the given oil to run the smooth hydraulic power system. Okay, to operate the smooth one. Okay. So what do you mean by this fluid conditioning through filters and strainer? So normally hydraulic components are very sensitive to the contamination. The cause of majority of the hydraulic system failures can be tracked back to the contamination, because of many of the hydraulic power system are failed due to this not doing proper filtration and strainer. Okay, not using proper this strainer and filter. Okay, hence a proper operation as long as long service life of a hydraulic power system is needed. Okay, so oil cleanness is one of the most important factor in hydraulic power system. Strainers and filters are designed to remove the dust particle from the hydraulic fluid. Okay, so both are designed such a way that it will remove the dust particle, that is unwanted particle which is not required to run the hydraulic power system. Okay, that is called as a filter and strainer. Both are components. Okay, both are devices. Okay. Next one is the filtration. So here I shown the images. So here the filtration is nothing but it is a mechanical or physical operation or mechanical devices which is used for the separation of a solid from the solid from liquid, that is a fluid, by interposing a medium through which only the fluid can passes. Okay, it is like a filtration. Okay, so the fluid that passes through this liquid layer is called as in a filtration. Okay, so I shown in the diagram. Okay, here beginning there are two layer will be there. From the top we are going to feed some liquid, but it is filtering and some dust particle remains there in the filtration part, and removing the after filtering we are going to circulate in the fluid we are going to get. Okay, normally filters are devices whose primary function is the retention of insoluble contaminants from the liquid by some fine porous medium we are going to get. Okay, these filters are used to pick up a small contaminant particle because they are able to accumulate them better than the strainer. Okay, normally as compared to filter and strainer, filters are going to filter very small particle. Okay, but the particle size removed by the filters are measured in microns. The smallest size particle that can be removed as small as just 1 micrometer. Okay, this is about the filtration. Okay, so what are the examples of filtration includes? Okay, so even if you, these are the nowadays. Okay, so the coffee filter to keep the coffee separate from the ground. Okay, and second example is HEPA, that is filter. HEPA filter in air conditioner to remove the particle from the air. And third example is belt filters to extract the precious metals in a mining area. Okay, next one is a horizontal plate with filter, known as also a sparkler filter. Okay, so furnace are used to filtration to prevent the furnace element from the falling within a particulates. Okay, so these are the some examples of normal day-to-day life filtration. Okay, next, what do you mean by strainer? So strainer is similar to this filter, but here not 1 micrometer, little small. Okay, strainer, it is a device through which a liquid is passed from purification, filtering or separation from the solid matter. Okay, anything that may be either cloth, screen, including screen or a cloth. Okay, used to strain or a liquid. Okay, both we are going to use in a strainer. Okay, here a strainer is nothing but it is a coarse filter. Okay, whose function is to remove the large particle from the fluid using a wire screen. Okay, so fluid flows more or less straight through it. Okay, so it does not provide any fine screening action as like in filter to do so something. Okay, so that is 1 micron, it is not filter but 1 micrometer. Okay, but it offers a less resistant to flow. Okay, the smallest size particle that can be removed by the strainer is small as 0.1 millimeter to 150 micrometer. These are the range between to filter this with the help of this strainer. Next is, what is the difference between filter and strainer? How filter and strainers are different? Okay, this is the most important question. But both are same only. The primary difference between the filter and the strainer is in the size of the particulates they are removing. Okay, the based on the size of removing they are classified. Okay, that is they are named as filter and strainer. Filter removes a particle that are smaller than 40 microns, whereas strainers remove the particulate that are larger than the 40 microns. This is the only difference. Oh, this is a very very important question. They may ask you in the GATE examination, that is a objective competitive examination, what you mean by filter and what you mean by strainer, what the smallest removal particle from the filter and what is the smallest particle size of a strainer. Okay, so just to remember that smaller than 40 microns is belongs to filter and larger than 40 micron belongs to strainer. Okay, next is one, what do you mean by fluid condition through filter and strainer? Okay, so fluid components, that is the hydraulic components, are very sensitive to the contamination and they may cause the majority of the hydraulic system failures can be tracked back to the contamination. Okay, so hence the proper operation and long service life of a hydraulic system is required and oiliness cleanliness is required, and these are the two primary functions. Okay, these are the two primary importance which are we are going to give the hydraulic power system. Okay, strainer and filters are designed to remove the foreign particle, that is a fine particles, from the hydraulic fluid. These two components are used almost 90% of the hydraulic power system. Okay, next one is a classification of filters. Okay, depending upon the amount of oil filtered by a filter is classified. That is, the first one is a full flow filters. Okay, so your diagram is there, that is filter element is there. Okay, in the diagram you can observe. So in this type of filter, the complete oil is filtered, full flow of oil must enter into the filter element, and it is and its inlet and must be expelled through a outlet after crossing the filter element fully. Okay, so this is an efficient filter. However, it includes the large pressure drops. This pressure drops increases as the filter gets blocked by the contamination. Okay, so this is a full amount of filtration we can done with the help of this. Okay, second one is a proportional filter. Proportional filter is nothing but partial filter. Okay, so here the system arrangement I shown here. In this system, hydraulic power system, so it is the only portion of oil is passed through the filter instead of entire volume, and the main flow is directly passed without filtering through a restricted passage area. So here the sum of how much you want to filter, that much of quantity of fluid can be filtered with the help of this proportional filter. Okay, that is called as bypass filter. And third one, that is next, how are filters and strainers are similar? Both are similar, how, on what basis? So both are similar. Filters and strainers do have a lot of common. Both product are designed to remove the suspended particle from the liquid or gases, but they are also both deliver similar benefits by protecting the downstream equipment and removing the impurities, that is containment, that might compromise the quality or integrity of the product. Sometimes both the devices are used with similar functions. Okay, in a hydraulic power system. So this is about what the difference between the filter and strainer. So just to remember that smaller than 40 micron is used for the filter and more than 40, that is used in a strainer. Okay, so this is about the concept of filtration and strainer. So both components are very very important in hydraulic power system to filter or to remove the dust particle, to fine particle, waste particle from the liquid present in the reservoir or tank. Okay, so this is about this, and this, if you remember, if you are not understanding, mean just you remember this, based on this just you apply thought, you will get. So the coffee filter, normally in the coffee shop they are using some coffee filter. That coffee filter is used to keep the coffee separate from the ground, that is a seeds. Okay, the coffee seeds can be separated from the coffee powder, that is a coffee fluid. So that is like this the filtration can be work in the hydraulic power system. Okay, I think this is about the diagram also. If you just observe the diagram, from the top we are going to feed the some liquid quantity, again they are going to separate and we are going to get the filtration amount of fluid. Okay, so just to observe this, this is about the filtration and strainer. Okay, so as compared to filter and strainer, the filters are most costly as compared to strainers, because strainer both are in the same shape, that is the same size, but normally the filter cost is high, because it will filter very fine particle of the given fluid. Okay, so to run the smooth operation of an hydraulic power system. And so one more important is here, these are the not only these type of filters, there are large number of filter classifications are there depending upon the use. Okay, so here for your syllabus only these are the two filtrations are there for your point of syllabus view, that is a full flow filters and partially flow filter. Partially flow filter is also called as a bypass filter, and this full flow filters is fully removed. If you use this device in hydraulic power system, means the entire fluid can be filtered and we are going to get a fine particle of fluid. Okay, and bypass means how much you want to filter, that much only we are going to get, we are going to filter this with the help of this proportional filters. Okay, so this is about the difference between filter and strainer. Okay, So here one more important topic is there, how difference, how here one more, how our filters or strainers are similar, both work, both the devices are similar, similar functions, but in filter less than 40 microns and more than 40 microns. Okay, so that is about this. And one more is, one more point you have to remember from here is, here this is smaller than 40 microns and larger than 40 microns. This is remember. Okay, so this question is very important. What do you mean by filter? Means 40 microns, lesser than 40 microns and larger than 40 microns. Okay, filters can be filtered smaller than 40 microns component, and this is the larger than 40 microns particles. Okay, I hope you understand this. Okay, strain, what is the difference between strainer and filter, okay, in hydraulic power system. Thank you.